Hey Capricorn. Okay, anyone who's new to Opal Oracle, welcome. Anyone returning, hi. Alright, Capricorn, so we're going to be using for this mid-month these beautiful, oh my god, Oracle cards that I received as a barter for reading from this wonderful, wonderful woman named Stasia from the Ukraine. So strong, so sweet. That person. Okay, so Capricorn, you are the seventh sign to come out. Okay? Let's keep pulling and see. Actually, out of all these cards, the majority of people are receiving around, there's about maybe 30 cards that have come out. I don't even know how many cards this is. Probably 100. Capricorn. Well, what I can say right now is Saturn is in Capricorn, okay? Gemini sort of received this message also where they are, Capricorn is I use, I build. It's about tools, okay? It's about, I haven't seen this one before. Awesome. How do you use the tools that you have? How do you use the tools that you have in a different way, in multiple ways? Okay? How are they utilized? There's something really important about that, okay? I see that you're concerned about how other people are attending to the goal at hand, okay? I see that certain people are letting go, and certain people are hanging on. But either way, all parties involved are going somewhere so that something can be revealed to them, okay? Definitely going somewhere, okay? There's an importance to keep a smile on your face. Okay, there's an importance for you to rest. I see that you're protected while you sleep, so you don't have to worry about that. Okay, I see you going, like bringing yourself out on a date would be really helpful for you. Okay, doing something fun for yourself. Look, both these characters have like striped pants on. They got weird outfits. It's just fun. They're dressing up because it's fun. They're going out and doing things because it's fun to them. Okay? Because it brings them joy. Particularly when you're feeling sort of like upside down about whatever situation is going on in your life right now. It wants you to go outside so that you can view it from a different perspective. Okay? But I will say that this is focusing, okay? She's specifically looking out upon a certain place in the world, okay? A certain I can't think of the word. It's maybe you're look. I heard you're looking in deep into the past. I see you also looking at the future, but I see that there's a need for you to look into the past, because when you're using this sort of tool, you're not paying attention to what's right in front of you, okay? And there's an importance for you to be able to do both of those things so that you can be the most grounded, okay? You want to be looking at the whole picture, because sometimes you think like, oh, just it's this and that, or making up the situation. But if you look deeply, more intently to your surroundings, you're going to see that there's more to the picture than you think that there is. Okay? And it will be teaching you about how to be cunning, how to be not sly in a negative way, like you're trying to be shady or pull one over on somebody by any means, or yourself. It's more about how do you maneuver through life, okay? You're a goatfish, Interesting. The Bears came out twice now. Because if we think about that, that's like the mandala effect, right? They used to say the Berenstain Bears. Now it's the Berenstain Bears. They made them Jewish. And it's like, it wasn't Stein. Even when I was a kid, it wasn't Stein. I remember that. And Nelson Mandela, like, didn't become president. They killed him in prison. You know what I mean? But there's something about that where there's a need for the collective to understand that there is a. We need to be more free in the comprehension of what reality is, okay? If we're bound to this one particular kind of way, we're going to miss all these little signs that help us recognize what the whole picture really is, okay? That's what manipulation is. That can be manipulating yourself, or, you know, unfortunately, some people manipulating others, okay? Now, don't judge me, I'm smoking. I think God, however weird it is, actually caused me to smoke. This is the last reading I'll be doing in this house. I'm moving, and I'm moving because I needed to know that my path in life, although I have free will, sometimes what we do with our free will, particularly when you have strong Capricorn in your chart, once you start doing something, once you've been doing something for so long, you don't give up, even if it's not suiting to you. And that can be, again, with other people, sure, but it also can very much be your environment, the physical world. You're an earth sign, okay? It can also mean where you get all wrapped up in your environment and you don't actually pay attention to and express what you're thinking about, how you feel, right? And because you do that, you become stubborn and lose sight of the fact that you have a path, your path is illuminated, it is right in front of you, okay? There's no need for you to be afraid. I see you're not eating. Like, most of you are probably sort of emotionally eating during this time too, which is okay, but just be, I mean, it'd be better if you didn't. But that's kind of like the cigarettes, like I was going to say, is I think that the reason why this is happening is because it needed to show the layers of something, okay? So I've been smoking since pretty much regularly since I was 18. I'm going to be 38 this year. That's 20, almost 20 years. Hi, baby. Now, for the last 10 years or so, have I been kind of like, you want to see Zoomy? She'll lighten your day.
Hi, Zoomy. Hi, baby. Where's Dad too? Yeah. Look how cute you are. Yes, you are. Yeah.
I love that. She looks freaking fine. So,
Good girl.
basically, the last 10 years or so, I've been kind of like, last 5 years ago, 5 years or so ago, I've been definitely more determined to complete this, okay? I wanted to rid myself so that when I get in the position where I want to use this as my vice, as my dealing mechanism, right? That's what psychologically happens that causes me to be like, oh, I do this when this happens so that I can deal with it, right? Because I don't feel centered, right? Instead of figuring out really why it is that I'm not feeling centered. Why is it that I'm not happy with myself? You know, what is that? And I see that during this time, you're going to be recognizing that that's extremely important. Okay? For everybody involved. This is important. This is a collective message for everyone. So we're all sort of going through this. Now, has the last 2 years been significant with this? Yes, sirree Bob. I've been saying it a lot. I've been talking to my friends with it a lot. I've been talking with strangers a lot, even in a sideways way, like just mentioning how I want to quit or that one time that I quit, or, you know, just sort of putting out there like what it is that I'm trying to change, you know, verbalizing it, turning into a spell. I even did rituals on full moons to like ask for it, to, like literally being like, please, 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 I want to rid myself of whatever it is. Azumi, get out the kitchen. Get out the kitchen. Good girl. Yes. It's not yet. 2 hours. She thinks it's dinner time because when I work at home, she doesn't, like, get it. She's like, what are we doing? Good girl, there's your monkey. So, the point is that the last few months, since last summer, actually, I've really decided that this isn't for me. It used to be. The reason why I started doing this behavior, is completely different than who I am now. Okay, so much has changed. In 20 years, how much has changed? You know? I've actually been giving this example to Taurus a lot, but like, it's important to share. Again, I think it's for everyone, because the thing is just because this has been a part of my life for so long, whether that would be, again, this is, we're talking about a physical thing, but it can be anything, it doesn't mean that it's good for you. It could be familiar, but it's not necessarily healthy anymore. And it's not to say that anything, that tobacco is a bad thing. Technically, tobacco has always been given to, like, shamans and to seers and people for an exchange to connect with spirit, okay? Part of the reason that I smoke is that I was so sensitive my whole life, and everyone brushed off that I had these powers, if you will, or whatever it was, abilities, certain abilities that they didn't understand, so they made me feel uncomfortable about it. So I started to feel uncomfortable about it. And one of the things that really settled me in that was this. Now, when I stop smoking, do I feel really uncomfortable? Yeah, when I start doing something different than I did before, completely changed my life. Literally every single fucking part of my life has been attached to this thing. I can do the dishes and smoke a cigarette. I can cook and smoke a cigarette. I can fucking jog and smoke a cigarette. Build a house and smoke a cigarette. I smoked cigarettes while I was on the computer. Or I smoked cigarettes while, you know, if I went for a dog walk or whatever. It was all intertwined, interlaced, woven together. So, what happens when I stop doing this? Well, it's wanting me to stop now. Well, what happens is again, you feel a little bit uncomfortable. But that's okay. That's how you figure out, like, again, you know how a person quits smoking, quits a major habit? You have to figure out why you started smoking. You have to know. If you do not know why you started smoking, you won't quit, because you don't really want to separate something that potentially, like, it's like you need to know, ultimately, whether it's a good decision or not, because again, once you start something, you've been doing it so long, for you to cut the string of that, for you to cut that off and start something completely, utterly new, that's frightening to you, right? It makes you feel like, oh, I don't know if I want to go in this water. I'm not a very good swimmer. I haven't swam in so long by myself. I went up to my waist, isn't that far enough? Ah, I'm getting back out, it's too cold. You know, like, oh, it's like, okay, again, cigarettes, like, I get stressed out, and then I smoke a cigarette. Or, I can get stressed out and be like, why am I really stressed out right now? You know? Why am I really stressed out right now? Is it because I'm not in touch with my own feelings? Possibly. Possibly. Do I need to become more in touch with my feminine side? Yes. Do I need to become more comfortable with the warp and weft, the ebb and flow of yourself, of your mind? Yes. Are you doing this process completely alone? No. I see for some of you, you have a child and it's really important to you. You also could have a little pet if you don't have a child. Or this very much can just be a friend that's exactly like you. Okay, something, again, that's been a part of your life for so long that it almost even looks like you. Okay? But the thing is you know that you've been going to the same restaurant for so long aren't you sick of the food? Don't you want to go somewhere else? Don't you want to explore and see what life has to offer, is what I heard, and I just got so tingly. And, you know, I think it was Aquarius that received this, but there's something about childlike, everyone received the childlike curiosity, but, like, childlike fun is important. The specific example I'd like to give is, when's the last time you, like, ran and just, like, dove onto your bed? Okay? Like, fearlessly. Like, I can fly for, like, 1 second. Okay? That this sort of fool, like, excitement of a brand new journey. Yeah, it's a little intimidating, but that's why you have the ability to be the fool. Maybe for some of you it would be like, you know, going to a new place you've never been before. A lot of people have been getting travel. But it's more about movement, but that can be internally or externally. But there's a strong need for the understanding of the yin and the yang, okay? Not the only thing unchanging is change. That's it. Because I'm moving in 1 week from today. And I don't want to be a smoker by the time I go there. But if I am a smoker by the time I go there, I want to know that in myself, I already know in myself that that choice has been made. Okay? And now I am going to be patient in that process. I have to be. I must be patient in that process because you're Capricorn. You don't rush anything anyway.
I mean, you're not a Taurus, but you're pretty close. 17th.
1657. What's that? 12 and 7. 19. That's the Sun card. That's Leo. You know, what makes your heart sing? I also see that for some of you, that if where you are is winter, you could also have a Leo that's really important to you, but where you are, where it's winter, you're wishing that it was the next season. I also see that you have been wishing for something to change for quite some time, okay? There's a lot of stars here, okay? Which represents healing. That's Aquarius, this card. We're in Aquarius season. It's awesome. It's Uranus. Uranus is about shakeups, man. It's about shaking things, literally shaking things up. It controls earthquakes and stuff, I think. But either way, it's things that happen sort of suddenly, unexpectedly, but it's for the greater good. It really is. Yeah, this card's been coming up a lot too. You have there's plenty of light to see even in the dark, okay? There's stars when there isn't this other kind of light, and then you have this light here. And lanterns are a light that doesn't take electricity, and Uranus actually rules electricity. So there's something about the importance of nature, okay? Of maybe that goes back to the seasons, too. What are the things that you love that don't take any electricity? They don't need any societal... This card has also been coming out a lot for everyone to let them know that you always, there is a beacon of hope right in front of you, okay? Even if you feel like you are in the middle of some sort of storm, you're fine. This is guiding your way so that you can reach the shore and feel stable again. And remember, you're a goldfish. You can swim in that water. And you have horns to protect yourself from anything that tries to eat you. And that you'll make it to shore. Okay? You will. Yeah. See? On the ground. Talking about all these wonderful experiences that you've had and where it is that you want to go and, like, using your imagination to get there. You know? Because really, for something to be able to be what it is that you wish for, everyone has to be on the same page. Okay? And sometimes we're on the same page for so long. There were times in my life when I was like, I think smoking's so cool, I'm gonna smoke forever. I thought it looked really sexy. I never could really smell it. My sense of smell's really diminished anyway. I don't even know if I actually technically have one. I can taste smell with my mouth, but anyway, I really never thought to myself, like, for a long, long time that I would ever separate myself from this. It wasn't natural to do so. But again, I changed who I was. My vibration changed. My thought pattern changed. My psyche changed. My feelings changed. My environment changed. My friends changed. My family even changed. And I think once I became more accepting of that change, and flowed with it versus fighting it, that's when I was able to just literally quit cigarettes after fucking almost 20 years. I just, one day I was like, I'm not gonna smoke anymore, and I just didn't. Now again, did I revert back to some sort of like habitual behavior? Yes, I did. Does it mean that I'm going to continue to do that? No. Is it some sort of test to show me what my triggers are, which is a propaganda word, what causes me to revert back to old patterning? Yes, that's important. It's again about remembering and attaching the string. What is it? Again, what made me start smoking? What makes you who you are? The parts that you don't like. Okay? Your life, the parts of your life you don't like. What is it? What is it? And can you change it? And are you accepting of those parts that you cannot change because they are outside of you and it's not your job? Because the more you come to understand that comprehension, the easier life will be. Really. Look at this. There's two cards of people looking up at clouds that look like animals. This is about imagination. It's about viewing what it is in front of you for what it is, right? And just being like, it's a fucking cloud. It's just a cloud. It's another cloud. It's another cloudy day. Or you can look at it like, wow, that cloud looks like a tiger. That cloud looks like a lion pig. You know, and if you're not able to shift it, if you're not able to I guess what I also see here is that I heard if your environment starts to shift, okay, and this can, I also sense it within your own mind, like within the way that you're thinking about it. And I see all sorts of people thinking about it, like there's a group of people, a small group, but a group. It's like one of the people in the group just is starting to look in a different direction, okay? There's something more that they want. They don't just... there's a need and a desire for things to shift. And that shift is coming because it wants you... It's like when the seas start shifting, right, and the storm comes, it's like it wants you to focus on this light. It doesn't want you to focus on the storm. Okay? I love these cards. My goodness. Yeah. It's about trusting yourself. Again, I see that children could be really important. Okay? But like knowing, just, and I get chilly on the right side of my body, which is your masculine, it's like, there's just such a need to have fun, okay? I know you're cardinal, I know you're serious. But there's a need to let go and have fun, okay? And to know that Just because you're an adult now and not a child doesn't mean that you're not allowed to have fun. Okay? You're allowed to go outside and smell the flowers. You're allowed to go outside and be excited and giggly that there's like, oh my god, there's a rainbow. You can do that. You really can. No one's going to judge you or think that you're a weirdo. Because Capricorn isn't doing some sort of stereotypical Capricorn thing. Maybe that's part of it. Okay, Taurus also had the same sort of message, like, for the last month or two, is like, just doing something that's completely out of character, because that is going to open up the ability for you to see the whole picture. Okay? And to know that the path, although it may seem like an incline at this point, there's a direction, okay? Like an unconscious sort of direction that's pushing you so that you can become more comfortable, okay? You hold the key. Yeah, another lighthouse. You hold the key. The light is right there. And you aren't alone. This card has also come up a lot. You're not alone. I see going by the water would be really helpful. I see hanging out with your friends, paying attention to your friends, being physically, because I know also Capricorn maybe isn't so physically, even though you're Earth sign, you're not the most physical person. Maybe sexually, but not necessarily like lovey-dovey. But there's a need for lovey-dovey. There's a need for sweetness and just sharing and figuring out who is in your life that is looking at life the same way as you, okay? Has the same perspective. And if they do not, then you have to let them go. And you have to let them go, firstly, within your mind, and then you have to let them go and even it out in your emotions, okay? And then you can let them go physically, in the earthly realm, okay? Because I see that you've already separated in a way from the wand realm, from the fire realm, from the passion realm, in certain ways. I'm not saying you're not passionate. I'm just saying that you've energetically already, again, I feel like I said about the cigarettes, last 10 years, last 5 years, last 2 years, last 6 months. Significant. And we already talked about, actually that, weird, Taurus keeps coming up for you, but like, this card doesn't want, yoga would be really helpful too. But last, I heard last 9 years too, but that was Taurus. I just did their reading also. Let's do one more. You know, and just remember that when you separate yourself from something, when you close something out, all that does is give you an opening to be able to free yourself from something so that something else can come in. Okay? And that's a really good thing. This balloon wouldn't work if it was made out of, you know, if it was heavy. It only works when it's light. It only works when it's goes with the flow. You can't make a balloon, a hot air balloon, take a quick left, flip a bitch. You know what I mean? It's not gonna, doesn't work like that. Yeah, there's definitely an opening. You're about to receive something really beautiful. Be open to it, okay? Know that you're strong enough to handle it, because you are. So look at this sweet couple, you know? They seem really young here. Maybe you're thinking about a past love or like love, like the beginnings of love. Where your cheeks hurt that you smile because you smile so much with one another, you know? Where your energy is so positive that this bird will just land in your hands. That's the kind of energy that God wants for you. Okay, for you to have in yourself. And, you know, the more that you receive, the more that you'll be able to, it's about giving and receiving. Okay, being open to that, really. Yeah, there's another couple with birds. You know? And I actually heard the term empty nest syndrome earlier, for those of you where your kids are, like, growing up. You know, like, what would you do if they were all gone? I'm sure, I'm not a parent, but I would presume that it's apparent for a parent to feel that way once their children have grown. And I see that writing about it and being outside, if you are going through those sorts of feelings, if you are going through significant changes in your life, I sense within the physical world and also within your own mind with this writing and the pen and the paper, is to, again, write about it, you know, that'll help you be able to see into deeper dimensions within yourself. How do you deal when you're, again, stressed out? What do? If you're not a smoker, like, what do? You know? And if you do feel like you're mostly healthy and you still become stressed, why is that? And just addressing it, you know? And then you can, because Saturn's in your first house, you're figuring out who you are. How do you use your own energy, you know, to build the world that you want? All right, I could pick these forever. I gotta cut this out. All right, I love you so much. I'll see you in March. Please take care of yourself. I hope you had a nice birthday. Bye.